हेलो, दिस इज़ माय नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन डायनामिक्स सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन लेक्चर 4। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस मोशन अंडर इनवर्स स्क्वायर लॉ। सो द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द थ्योरम इज़ अ पार्टिकल मूव्स इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विथ एन एक्सलरेशन विच इज़ ऑलवेज डायरेक्टेड टूवर्ड्स अ फिक्स्ड पॉइंट ओ एंड वेरीज इनवर्सली एज द स्क्वायर ऑफ इट्स डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ओ। इफ द पार्टिकल स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम रेस्ट एट अ पॉइंट ए ऑन द लाइन सच दैट ओ ए इज इक्वल टू स्मॉल ए, वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन द मोशन। सो लेट द पार्टिकल स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम रेस्ट फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ए अलॉन्ग द स्ट्रेट लाइन ए ओ ए डैश such that OA is equal to OA dash is equal to small a. Let P be the motion या position of the particle after any time t such that OP is equal to x. Then by the statement of the theorem acceleration is inversely proportional या acceleration varies inversely as the square of its distance from O. So we will get d2x by dt square is proportional to 1 by x square. If we remove this proportionality sign, we have to take a proportionality constant. So we will get d2x by dt square is equal to minus mu by x square. Take it as equation 1. Here mu is the proportionality constant and negative sign is taken because x decreases with time t. Multiplying both sides of equation 1 by 2 dx by dt, we will get 2 dx by dt into d2x by dt square equal to 2 dx by dt into minus mu by x square from the property of differentiation. This can be written as d by dt of dx by dt whole square is equal to 2 mu d by dt of 1 by x. So on integration, we will get dx by dt whole square equal to 2 mu by x plus integration constant c1. Give it as equation 2. Now initially at a dx by dt equal to 0 because the particle starts from rest, so its velocity is 0 and x is equal to a. So though substituting these values in equation 2, we will get c1 is equal to 2 mu by a. Now substituting the value of c1 in equation 2, dx by dt whole square is equal to 2 mu 1 by x minus 1 by a. So dx by dt is minus under root 2 mu under root a minus x by ax. Give it as equation 3. And again, this is the expression for velocity. So we have to take a negative sign because x decreases with time t. Now, equation 3 further can be written as under root x by under root a minus x dx is equal to minus under root 2 mu by a dt. Give it as equation 4. Now putting x is equal to a cos square theta, differentiating this with respect to theta, we will get dx is equal to minus 2 a cos theta sin theta d theta. So equation 4 implies under root a cos theta by under root a is common, under root 1 minus cos square theta. In the place of dx, we have minus 2a cos theta sin theta d theta is equal to minus under root 2 mu by a dt. So after simplification, under root a is cancelled out and under root 1 minus cos square theta is sin theta. So cos theta by sin theta into negative sign is also cancelled out from the left hand and right hand side. So 2a cos theta sin theta d theta is equal to under root 2 mu by a dt. This further can be written as sin theta is cancel out. So a 2 cos square theta d theta is under root 2 mu by a dt, and 2 cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta or cos 2 theta plus 1. So a cos 2 theta plus 1 d theta is equal to under root 2 mu by a dt. So on integration, we have a sin 2 theta by 2 plus theta is equal to under root 2 mu by a t plus an integration constant c2. Take it as equation 5. Now, since x is equal to a cos square theta, this implies theta is equal to cos inverse under root x by a. Also, x is equal to a cos theta implies cos theta is equal to under root x by a. And sin theta is under root 1 minus cos square theta. So, this is equal to under root 1 minus x by a or under root a minus x by a. And sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta into cos theta. So, it can be written as 2 under root a minus x by a into under root x by a. We are converting all the terms of theta in terms of x by using this result, this relations. So, equation 5 can be written as a under root a minus x by a into under root x by a plus cos inverse under root x by a is equal to under root 2 mu by a t plus integration constant c2. Initially at a, x is equal to a and t is equal to 0. So, substituting these values, we will get c2 is equal to 0. So, if we put c2 is equal to 0, we will get a under root ax a minus x divided by a after simplification, and opening the bracket, we will get this step plus a cos inverse under root x by a is equal to under root 2 mu by a t. A is cancelled out, so this further can be written as under root x a minus x plus a cos inverse under root x by a is equal to under root 2 mu by a into t. Give it as equation 6, and from here t is equal to under root a by 2 mu in bracket under root x a minus x plus a cos inverse under root x by a. Give it as equation 7. So, equations 1, 3, 6 and 7 gives the motion of particle. Equation 1 gives acceleration. Equation 3 gives velocity. Equation 6 gives distance. And equation 7 gives time. Now, when particle reaches at O, then x is equal to 0. So, equation 1 implies d2x by dt square is equal to minus infinity. Equation 3 implies v is equal to minus infinity, and equation 7 implies t is equal to under root a by 2 mu into a pi by 2. This is equal to pi by 2 a to the power 3 by 2 by under root 2 mu. Since at O the velocity and accelerations are negative, so the particle moves to the left of O, that is towards a dash. Now we will discuss the case when particle reaches at a dash. So in this case, equation 1 implies d2x by dt square is equal to minus mu by a square as x is equal to a here. Equation 3 gives velocity v is equal to 0. So at a dash, v becomes 0, which shows that particle comes to rest for some instant and move towards O with acceleration minus mu by a square, passes over O and comes to A and hence retraces its path. So, the motion of the particle is SHM and its time period is 4 into small t. The time period is denoted by capital T. So, capital T is equal to 4 into small t. Substituting the value of small t, we will get 4 into pi by 2 into a to the power 3 by 2 divided by under root 2 mu. This after simplification can be written as under root 2 by mu pi a to the power 3 by 2. If we square both sides, we will get t square is equal to 2 pi square a cube by mu. So, from here we can write that t square is proportional to a cube, since 2 pi square by mu is constant, and so the square of the time period varies directly as the cube of the amplitude. From here you have to discuss the motion under inverse square law. In my next lecture, I will discuss some numerical on simple harmonic motion, and then we will start our next chapter, Hooke's law.